In this lesson, we will learn how to define cell names. This Excel file contains information about a ball that has dropped from a building. The time the ball has fallen, t, is 5 seconds. The initial velocity of the ball, v0, is 0 meters per second. And the gravitational acceleration, g, is negative 9.81 meters per second squared. With this information, we can calculate the velocity of the ball, v, at that moment in time. The velocity at time t is equal to v0 plus g times t. In terms of cell addresses, we have equals B3 plus B4 times B2. The ball is traveling downward at 49.05 meters per second. We can write this formula using symbols rather than cell addresses by defining cell names. I will show you three different ways to define cell names. Select B2, then right-click and select Name a Range at the bottom. In the Name box, type the name you want to associate with cell B2. In this case, cell B2 contains a time, so we will type T. Notice that the cell name refers to equals sheet 1 exclamation point dollar sign B dollar sign 2. This means that cell B2 of sheet 1 contains the value that will be associated with the name T. Now, select B3 and click on the formulas at the top of the screen. Click on Define Name and type V0 for the name and select OK. This is the second way you can define a cell name. If you want to see all the cell names you have created, select on the Name Manager. Notice that both T and V0 are listed. You also can define a cell name by typing the name directly in the cell's name box in the upper left-hand corner. Click on cell B4 and go to the name box and type G. This is the third way you can define a cell name. Now we can use symbols to calculate the velocity instead of cell addresses. In cell B7, type equals V0 plus G times T and hit enter. Notice that we get the same answer as before, -49.05 meters per second. Also notice that the cell names appear in the formula bar instead of the cell addresses. There are rules for defining cell names. The first character must be a letter, an underscore, or a backslash. The remaining characters may be letters, numbers, periods, or underscores. You cannot use spaces in a cell name, but you may use an underscore or a period to separate words. For example, if you want to name a cell sales tax, you can remove the space, place an underscore, or place a period between the two words. A cell name may contain up to 255 characters. Cell names are case insensitive. For example, you can type the name sales with any combination of upper and lowercase letters. And finally, the cell name cannot be a cell reference. For example, A3, T23, AC1, and Z$100 are all invalid cell names.